Unfortunately, the Islamic concept of mahr has been widely misunderstood. Those who are obsessive with the contractual element in Muslim concept of marriage regard it as consideration. Those who are more familiar with dowry confuse it with the same. The fact is that mahr is neither consideration nor dowry. It has a unique position of its own. To understand the Muslim concept of dowr thoroughly, let us go through some of the definitions of dowr by eminent jurists of Islamic law. According to Tayyibji, dowr or mahr is a sum that becomes payable by the husband to the wife on marriage, either by agreement between the parties or by operation of law. Sir Abdul Rahim defines it as, dowr is either a sum of money or other form of property to which the wife becomes entitled by marriage. It is an obligation imposed by law on the husband as a mark of respect for the wife. According to Bailey, dowr is not the exchange or consideration given by the man to the woman for entering into the contract, but an effect to the contract imposed by the law on her husband as a mark of respect to its subject, the woman. Justice Mahmood defines dowr as follows. Dowr under Muhammadan law is a sum of money or other property promised by the husband to be paid or delivered to the wife in consideration of the marriage. Even while no dowr is expressly fixed or mentioned at the marriage ceremony, the law confers the right of the dowr upon the wife. He further elaborates this point as under. Dowr may be regarded as a consideration for connubial intercourse by way of analogy to the contract or sale. This observation is subject to serious doubt, as Sir Abdul Rahim correctly points out that it is not a consideration in the modern sense of the term, but an obligation imposed by the law upon the husband as a mark of respect to the wife. We know that if dowr were a consideration, it would always be prompt and specified. But the law allows deferred dowr, which is payable on the dissolution of marriage. And even when it is not expressly fixed or mentioned at the marriage ceremony, the law confers the right of dowr upon the wife. The law provides that dowr can be fixed before, at the time of, or after the marriage. Dowr is therefore different from consideration. It is in fact an effect to the contract imposed by law on the husband. In Nasra Begum versus Rizwan Ali, the court held that where there has been an agreement between the parties at the time of their marriage with regard to the amount of dowr payable by the husband to the wife, the payment of such dowr amount becomes recoverable under agreement. We know that the binding character of dowr is that it has been divinely ordained. The true nature of dowr can be found in the Holy Quran itself. Holy Quran uses the word sadaqa for dowr. Sadaqa is a derivative of siddiq, which means truth, regularity, and friendship. Dowr in this Quranic sense is the symbol of truthfulness and regularity of the friendship of husband and the wife. Dowr is to strengthen cooperation between the spouses and add to the dignity of the woman.